front rack, rear foot elevated, so on your bench, split squat. What we're trying to do here is we're not actually trying to load a front squat, meaning you have to load the bar. Okay, you can use the plate, you can use dumbbells, you can use kettlebells, anything that can load in front, so whether it's a goblet or just resting on, holding on to the plate, to create more demand on the core, especially in the front and your abdominal wall or transversus abdominis, which will then support your core a lot more because it'll make you a lot more, a lot stronger through and keep your spine safe and healthy. So first we'll talk about how to sit up properly because I still want to mistake through this. First thing you have to understand, like, this is an exercise we only focus on the front foot, okay, not the back foot. So we're not trying to use the back foot at all. We're trying to minimize it as much as we can. Obviously there's a bit more help than it would be if it's a, if it was a strong front squat or a pistol squat. So foot on top, okay, ankles at the right connection. My foot is completely flat. I'm not curling my toes trying to put on. I'm not trying to push off at all. It's purely there resting on the bench. From this position, what I want to do here is I want to find a position where my foot is, okay, not too much forward, not too far back. Because if it is, we tend to change angle while we're moving. And we're trying to move in an upright position, not in a angle position. So ideally, I want my front foot, so to make sure it loads properly into the leg, to be basically mimicking the position of my chest. So if my chest is down, my chin should be in the exact same position, okay? So I'm gonna drive to the tripod of my foot. So my big toe, the outside of my heel is gonna make the tripod, I'm gonna press through. I'm gonna get set, so it's gonna be a front rack. In this case, like, you're more of an upright position. Yes, keep that in mind. If you're not sure, just practice it with your hands by your side and just drive up, okay? Drive up, come back down, back up. So yeah, you wanna mimic that position through, so it's the same on both, so drive. On the front squat, obviously, or front rack, you are more in an upright position, that's fine. So your angle, your shin might move a little bit, and then you're gonna drive up, back down, drive back up, okay? Don't start from the ground. You don't have to go down to the ground. As long as you're really close to the 90 degree bend in your knee, you're completely fine. Just be aware that it might add a bit more strain on your hip as you're going down, because it stretches it out a bit. That is not an issue. The biggest thing is making sure we're driving more in an upright position, and it's the front leg doing most of the work. At 90% to 95%, front leg's doing all the work, not the back.